Okay, this is lesson 3.1b. I think we're getting, or I'm getting goofed up with the numbers here, but it's 3.1b for right now. It's called branching statements or conditional statements. And the first type of conditional statement we're going to do is the if-then. Now, we already talked about it, so there's a little bit of redundancy here. But what I want to do is I want to go over this again. And then I also want to add a few things to it. These are called Boolean expressions, but then these Boolean expressions can be made so they're a little bit more sophisticated using using conjunctions and disjunctions. So what you were dealing with before, and what you've already done, is that you wrote a program that said if some condition is met, then perform these actions inside the braces. Now you've done that already. For example, you said if x is greater than 65, print you passed. Now what I want to show you is some of these other ones. You know that greater than is, that's the symbol for it. That's why we use that one the first time. I think we use either greater than or less than. You know that less than is that symbol. But what you probably didn't know was that greater than or equal to is that. Now typically in mathematics, you know greater than or equal to is a greater than sign with a line underneath it. But in programming, the way that you would symbolize that is greater than with an equal to afterward. So you know now that less than or equal to is going to look like that. Now the other two, notice how I didn't put equals as the first one, because that's the weirdest one actually. Not equal to. Usually it's an equal sign with a diagonal slash through the equal sign, but not equal to in programming is typically exclamation point equals. This one's going to take a little bit of explanation. I'm not going to do it here. I'm just going to quickly explain why do you have to have two equal signs for equal to. The bottom line is because an equal sign in programming, at least in Java and C++, is more of an assignment than it is saying, is this equal to this? And what I mean by that is, remember when you had formulas that would say x equals, you know, s plus 2? You're assigning to x s plus 2. If you want to say if something is equal to something, you can't use one equal sign because it will assign it that value automatically and automatically say that it is equal to it. So you have to subvert that a little bit by saying equals equals. I know it's weird, but you'll get used to it. You really, when do you use the double equals in an if statement? For right now, just think of it that way. Next. So if you want to say if x is greater than or equal to 65, print something, that's how it would be done. Right there. If you want to say if x is not equal to 65, that's what that looks like. This one's going to get a little trickier. If, now listen carefully, if you want to say something like if x is greater than 65 and it's less than 70, print you passed. Let's go back to what that says. This says if x is bigger than a 65, but it's less than 70, then print you passed. Well, actually, it probably should be print you barely passed. Isn't that what that kind of means? If x is greater than 65, that means they passed. And it should be greater than or equal to, but in less than 70. They just barely passed. It was either a 65, 66, 67, 68, or 69 that they got. Now, the way you would have to program that, obviously, is not what I have up there inside of the parentheses next to the if. It's closer to this. If x is greater than 65 and x is less than 70, do you notice, and I'll go back, do you notice that I had to say x twice? I had to say if x is greater than 65 and if x is less than 70. So I had to specify by using x twice. Now that's not the only thing you have to do. You actually have to put both the x is greater than 65 and the x is less than 70 in their own set of parentheses. But we're not done. Because now, once you've done that, you've got to put that entire thing in its own set of parentheses. So there's double parentheses here. The if statement needs its own big set of parentheses. Each condition needs its own set of parentheses, and then you can put and in the middle. And I wish it was that easy, but guess what? You can't use and, at least not the word and. There's a symbol for and. Don't ask me why they chose this one, but there it is. It's two n symbols. That's above the 7 usually on a keyboard. So now this says if x is greater than 65 and x is less than 70, print you barely passed. Let's do another one. What if we said we're going to use an or statement this time? This one doesn't make any sense, but if x is greater or equal to 10 or less than 1, then print hello. So if x is greater or equal to 10, so bigger than 10 or equal to it, or it's less than 1, print out hello. Well, again, we'll just leave it hello. You can't have it that way. You would have to say if x is greater than or equal to 10 or x is less than 1. You would have to have each one of those in their own set of parentheses. And then you would have to have that encompassed by one big set of parentheses. And as you probably already know, you can't use the word or. You have to use its symbol, which are two vertical lines. And that's above, if you look above the enter key, you'll see a backslash. But if you hit shift, you'll see that it looks like two little vertical lines, but it's one vertical line. If you hit shift and then hit vertical line, that's what it's going to look like when it prints out. So this says if x is greater than or equal to 10 or x is less than 1, print hello. So that's how you use conditional statements with ands and ors. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to slowly, by giving you one little assignment and then another little assignment and then another little assignment, have you get better and better at this. All right, we're done.